So this has been in the making for a minute, man. We did all those virtual and all those recording interviews because pandemic and his babies wanted to stop you from coming down to this radio station.
Man, but we're here now. So.
But we finally made it happen, man. Yeah. And I'm so excited, man, to finally have you, man, in the studio, man. Call me Israel is in the building, man. And so, man, number one, man, welcome to Fusion Radio with Brian Stinson and YTS Keys, man. And once again, man, excited about definitely chopping it up with you, man,
yes,
and definitely getting to your movement, man.
Thank you for having me, by the way.
I was telling Keith that, man, you know, you collaborated with another one of my brothers, man, Leo West.
Oh, yeah.
And Leo is so dope, man, and everything, so I can't wait till he hears it and listening audience hears it, man, because Leo is just so super
that's my
talented.
Boy. We've been locked in, actually, whole pandemic. That's when we met, like, right before. Pandemic kind of locked us in the studio. We just been rap ever since, just recording, shooting videos, been nonstop.
All right, so, man, first, before we get into anything, man, Call Me Israel. Man, story behind how you settled on that as your artist name, any special meaning behind it?
Yeah, it's actually a very, very kind of deep sentimental meaning for me. Again, it came when I was living in Los Angeles, California. I kind of just went on this, I wouldn't kind of say like a hotep trip, but it was like a discovery of myself, our people, who we were. God kind of just put it on my heart to just discover. No, he told me to read the Bible and kind of find out who my people were from that. And so I started doing that and then just lining stuff up with like historical books outside of that and just kind of came to the understanding that we were Hebrews. And the word Israel comes from the Bible as well. It means to wrestle with God. So upon that self-discovery, I just kind of saw it as like me wrestling with like a higher version of myself. You feel me? Like my humanity wrestling with that version of myself that I'm trying to get to and that often getting in the way. So that's where Israel comes from. Like the knowledge of me knowing that my people are Hebrew and not just like African-American. And also just a meaning of me just trying to wrestle with the higher version of myself to try to get there.
For sure. I like that. See, I like people when, like, they come up with their musical names, like, it got some type of meaning to it. I feel like a lot of people just be like, okay, my name is this, so I'm going to call myself
like
that.
Like a little something.
You feel me?
Little Poochie.
Yeah, something that they mama named them, so they just like, this is my name in the hood, so I'm going to call myself that. No, you gotta give it some type of purpose, you feel me?
Yeah.
So, like, when did you necessarily start on that path and be like, okay, I could be doing this, I could be doing that, but I want to do music, though. So when did you come up with that decision?
Pretty early, honestly. I was still in high school when I first started recording. It was about 2012. And I kind of started from poetry. And then that just kind of, I started writing songs first for like singers. But at the time, I couldn't really like sing like that. So I'm like, nah, I should probably rap. You feel me? And it just kind of just came out then. And from then, it was just, you know, nonstop. And I went to L.A. thinking that, you know, that was going to be like my big break, like everybody else think. You feel me? Like. But really, it was kind of just my moment to kind of get to know God in a better light. And through that, get to know myself. That's kind of when I realized when I kind of came back, I was like, oh, it wasn't meant for me to go out there for that. It was meant for me to understand who I am, like as a man, as an artist, you know, as a servant, and bring that back to my music. And now, you know, we rocking. I've been able to actually get signed since I've been back to like a distribution deal on the Universal. So now music is being released under that. So, you know, we're going to see what that's like. You know, that's a new experience for me, so.
Okay. So when you was talking, I heard you say like in the early stages of your career, you was doing poetry. So like, talk to me a little bit about that, because in some type of way, I look at poetry like it's like rap, but it's like, it's kind of like a different format. So like, explain it how it was with you as far as like poetry.
I would say poetry is like the fundamental to just like music. Period, because whether it's rap, whether it's song, it's still rhyming. It's all just kind of spoken word-ish. You feel me? We just putting it with beats. So, that was just the early way of me expressing myself, just expressing, like, the things that I would go through life as, like, a kid. You feel me? Like, seeing my parents divorce, you feel me, and stuff like that, and not really understanding how to process it, just kind of just writing. So everything was just rhyming and just, you know, I've actually done a little spoken word. I have a visual to a spoken word I have out called Love's Void. I kind of veered away from it, I'll say, once I got more into the musical aspect of it, but I go back and forth, you know, depending on like what the performance is going to be set up like, I'll do that.
Okay, okay. So I heard you say you took a trip to Cali. You took that leap of faith to go out there to Philly because you felt like in some type of way that would help your career.
Yeah.
So like, what were certain things that you were experiencing out there that you weren't experiencing out here in the city? Because I know like that's a whole different environment. So like, what certain things that stood out to you out there?
Well, them Cali fires is one thing that kind of stand out. You're not really used to that at all. Seeing everything just burn around, just kind of surreal. It's kind of like I was like in a movie scene, like at all times, you feel me? But Cali was dope. You know, I thought Cali had a lot to offer. It allowed me to express myself a little more creatively, had a little more freedom doing that because I feel like it just kind of catered to like just creatives. You feel me? Whether you dancing, whether you, you know, doing music, poetry, like anything, like it's just kind of set up for like whatever you need. And the landscape is so dope itself. Like I ain't never been to a place where it's just everywhere you look, it's just a mountain range. You feel me? So that was the scenery itself was definitely something that I kind of took away from being there. But there's a lot of dark moments too, a lot of dark times. The people are definitely different. You know, I got some great friends, long lasting friends that I have from there still, but just overall, like, I say the people kind of left like me a little antisocial, you feel me? Like from being there, I was like, okay, I'm not fuck with people. Not mess with people for a while, excuse my language.
It be like that though. Yeah. So like usually on this show, I try to keep it like strictly like music and stuff like that. I don't really try to go too much into people's personal lives, which I won't do right now, but in some type of way, to really understand who you are as an artist and why you transition into the artist you are now and why you make the music you make, we have to understand you as a person in some type of way. So, like, if I'm not mistaken, I heard you say once you went out there, that's kind of like when you started really getting more in tune with yourself and, like, God and stuff like that. So, like, was it a specific moment that had you feel like that, or it was just like you just told yourself, like, man, I need to make a change. It's something that I need in my life that I don't have right now.
Yeah, it was a specific moment. I would say like in the year 2016, it was a combination of a few things, honestly. It was me seeing just how our people were just kind of being gunned down so many times by police, just like back to back. We just kind of saw just event after event after event. And also me kind of like losing friends. One in particular was like one of my best friends at the time who I had lost. Not to like death or anything, but just because like we kind of crossed that line and started dating, and I kind of realized like, you know, I'm not who I thought I was. So that just kind of like was a wake up call for me. And then once I kind of like all of that just kind of affected me on a spiritual level to where I feel like my passion for my arts kind of just kind of like got blocked. You feel me? And I wasn't able to create. I wasn't able to write. Like, and so I was just kind of backed into a corner. It was kind of like a Job experience, you feel me? To where I'm just like losing stuff left and right. And it's kind of just putting me in a moment to where I have to like go face to face with God and be like, okay, Lord, like, what's up? You feel me? Like, cause this ain't the move. You feel me? This ain't the vibe. I know this ain't what you called me out here for. So, you know, it's obviously some self-reflecting I got to do. So that kind of just brought me to that moment. It's just like, you know, you got to wake up, get back to your stuff, get back to yourself so that you can do, you know, what you need to do with your purpose and your music. You know, because it's like you said, it's all connected. Knowing who you are, you know, translates to the music that you make. You feel me? And me just kind of being inspired by God in the Bible. Like, that's my whole writing perspective. It's how I, like, articulate the things that I see, how I go through, how it affects me emotionally, spiritually, mentally type stuff.
Okay, I like that. So in some type of way, we did get kind of in-depth into you in some type of way. So I want to give people a chance to actually see how you are on the mic, you feel me? Test you out, see how you coming. So we got this song, you feel me? Golden Child, you feel me? Featuring your boy, you feel me? Leo Webb.
Yes.
So like in some type of way, tell us about like how was that process as far as making that song and like how did that whole collab with you and Mr. West come together?
Well, like I said, me and my boy Wes, we've been locked in for like going on 4 years now. So this came about just how pretty much everything else come about. Like sometimes we just go in the studio and we with nothing, you know, no plan but just to go in there. You feel me? We hear beats, we just write. This particular song, he actually sent me his verse first. He had his verse recorded already. And he was like, yo, what you think about this? And I listened to it and like instantly like fell in love with it. It was the beat first. It was just a vibe. And then once I heard his verse, I was like, oh yeah, I see where you're going with this. You feel me? Like, mm-hmm. And I had put my first verse to it and sent it back to him, but I didn't really know, you know, where he wants to go with the song. So we kind of had that camaraderie. It was like, okay, if you send me something first, I'm gonna let you, I'm gonna do my thing, but I'm gonna kind of see where you, what you want to do with it. You feel me? But he was like, oh, I want you to take over. You feel me? That's yours. I was like, oh, okay, bad. So I just did what I did. And then we shot the video and that is what it is.
For sure, man. So just based off that, you feel me? I'm definitely excited to hear what this song sound like. So we finna go ahead and get into it. So it's your boy, YTS Keys, Brian Stinson, you feel me, of Fusion Radio, but we finna get into this. Call me Israel, Golden Child.
Up high we go, Wi-Fi we flow, high tide we rose. No time to grow, my mind, I know what time it is when I
tap into that real. Might tap into that drill. Might just flip on that kill switch. Might just on your wait.
Savage on my display, man. You and your parlay. Might speed off on that Harley, like.
Pardon my disrespect, disrespectfully. I've been up late just cooking up that recipe. I like my bread to come with cheese incessantly. I've been getting way too used to saying rest in peace.
Losing my breath, I'm like, hold up.
Pick up that pace, I'm like, grow up. I cut them off, I'm like, solo. Only real, black man, look, just stable.
I stack the cards on the table. I play the ace if you say so. I cannot speak on no fable. She feeling me, see them pesos. Get hella geek off that pillow.
If Simon said, then it's broco. Please do not try me, I'm loco. Nickel and diamond, I stay broke.
Nickel and diamond, I stay broke.
This one for my kinfolk. This one hit a intro. My life behind closed doors. Think about what my time comes. Please don't hit my line. Said don't hit my line. Think you reach the dial tone. No more bringing lies on. I can't go in blindfolded. But what I do see, living color my true peace. Who he? Blowing no trees and motivating to the loosely. No sleep. Dreaming the days when nightmares gon' turn to reality. Straight bullet for all the casualties. This was my shot and I hit it with axe. Ayy, no album, I've been with the practice. Ayy, hungry to then give me a play. That's why I'm throwing my feelings away. Yo, I'm chasing a bag today. Mama, I hope that you proud of me. I'm growing, I own up to all mistakes. Yeah, I got 2 kids to raise. I'ma do the night just to make sure they see in the brighter days. Trip, not this a tidal wave. Cake, but now you can never be saved. I can never be saved. Can't die with none of that. The money you save, yeah.
Funny thing about my wealth, it ain't worth trying to measure with a C-note. Like C-Lo, super green, but I emote. Emo, dark child. I speak no evil, built off when I eloped. And I can't cross roads if I'm too left. I'm right again from the start, I was all in. My fears in the dark, I was lost in. Nightmares, such a spiral, a cycle of life here, but I'm frightful, I might go. Light years, hands on, so I might hold. These tears, hands on, gotta build my criteria.
How I feel,
when they think about me,
how I think,
when they link without me.
Should I link,
probably heal without me.
Will I heal,
if I stayed around, I start to feel like a golden child. When I'm a silver lining, unrefined and unrequited. Undeniable, not invited, my advice is perfect timing. Hit the Heimlich, curse behind me. The skirts are blinding, curves are winding. Cross the field just to look behind me. Family curses, they seem to find me. Defenseless, my wish list. Never they come with a handout. I stand out, hearts concealed, I'm a cast out. Like outcast, I outlast every genre you hand out. Homicide these, with homonyms, and hill them right back for synonyms and fan out. Yeah, with every verse I rehearse is a mercy, you pump fake. I throw the bouquet for you. I labor to say my grace for a man down.
Up high we go, Wi-Fi.
Can I tell y'all I'm the luckiest person in the world? Because I have been absolutely waiting to have him in the studio to tell him face to face how dope he is, man. We've talked about it, and like it gives me an opportunity to jump into a recent accomplishment, poised to break out artist from Vocalogue. And
appreciate you.
I mean, I think you're like the second or third artist that we've had here that Vocalogue has had as their poised to break to artist.
Yeah, shout out to Vocalo too, because they support me like with everything I send them. This is, I think this is the second time that they've kind of posted me as like a poised to break out. It's like every time I send them a song, they're like, okay, yeah, We got you. And the last song I sent them was like way past the deadline, but they liked it so much that they was like, yo, we gonna spin this. So and, I appreciate that.
I mean, you hear the quality, you hear the next level. I mean,
thank you, man.
I mean, the collaboration with you and Leo West was like incredible, yeah. Man. The synergy.
Because he's definitely doing this thing. He inspires me a lot, too. You feel me? Like, he is one of the few artists that pushes me to kind of just be my best self. Just seeing him do him. You feel me? Like, even though, you know, we are, you know, signed artists, we still, like, most of the grind is on us. You feel me? Like, and our managers let us know this. Like, they told us, you know, we're not going to work harder than you. You know, so we just here to manage what y'all doing and manage y'all career and help facilitate. But all the legwork is still on us. You feel me? Like, from getting the shows to getting the music made to just pretty much everything. So just seeing him do that pushes me to like, okay, I got to stay on top of myself. You feel me? Because this man got 2 kids. You feel me? I don't. So I ain't got no excuse. Yeah. You feel me? So he grinds. So
he grinds.
Yeah.
All right, so those of you that are just tuning in right now, man, on the radio, checking in via Facebook Live, Brian Simpson, YTS Keys, man. And Face You See is a super dope artist right here from the Shy, man. Call me Israel. Now, you know I'm finna clown you for a second, right?
What I do?
Why you sent me that picture for the flyer, right? You straight looking like D'Angelo, like you sent something to. How does it feel?
Okay. It's giving straight R&B vibes.
Straight looking like that album cover. You know that album cover on top. Don't listen to D'Angelo. They back here busting up live because they know what I'm talking about. They know that. That's true. You know what I'm talking about.
It's funny, though. It's funny.
Beth, I don't know. That's just kind of my vibe. You feel me? Like, I try not to look like everybody else.
But so. You do, man, like that whole... Like, that's the same album that had Devil's Pie and all of those different dope, man. Come on, man. You straight, man. But How Does It Feel was the record that everybody remembers and everything. You straight look like you finna do the How Does It Feel video.
Yeah. I actually was going to use that as a concept for one. I was like, look, this is what we need to do. I want to circle around me. You feel me? I'm like, no.
Hey, no, it's crazy you said that. Because when I went to go get him, I'm looking at him. Look like the person that was on the. I'm like, oh, man. You feel me? I said the same thing in my brain. I didn't want to put it out there like that. I'm like, man. Yes. You feel me?
We gonna figure it out. Switch it up on them. You got to switch it up on them.
Oh, man, ain't nothing wrong with that, man. That album sold a lot of copies, man. A lot of women went out there and bumped that album, man.
Hopefully, I can have the same effect.
Yeah.
You know, but that's what it be. The pictures draw me in. You feel me? It's like they be thinking they getting one thing, and they be like, nah, boom, here we go. I'm gonna switch it up. And they just roll with it because we here now. So
one thing I did want to ask before we get up out of here and stuff like that, like, what's next, though? Like, I see, because from listening to that song, like, I don't necessarily know which one, if it was either you or Wes, but, like, in one part of that song, y'all kind of switched it up and got, like, on some Kendrick Lamar type of thing, you feel me? Like, it was like, but it sounded good, though, you feel me? So, like, if you in that type of lane, because I like the lane you in as far as, like, music. So with that type of lane, what do you feel like you could take it, though? Like, what's your...
I mean, I feel like I could take it wherever I want to take it. That's kind of what I've been doing now. I feel like I have such a versatile style and approach to all my music. Sometimes you'll hear some of my songs and, like, I may sound like a different person. But definitely whenever I do collabs with Leo and other artists, I kind of step into their world. But just where I'm taking it right now, I'm kind of working on another project. Another album's called Me Learning Me. So Golden Child is going to be obviously the first single off that. I'm not going to say I have like this as packaged as the first one, just in terms of like, you know, how I'm going to release it. I'm kind of just releasing it as singles right now. And then once I'm done with the actual project, I'll just drop, you know, that around the end of the year. But that's what we're doing with it.
So I want to go back, man, to, man, that compilation, man, called Tax Season, man. That's, we're going to give them some homework to do here on this radio show. We like to give people homework to do. So their homework is to check out their project. But you're going to give them a little tease as to why they should check out their project.
Well, like my boy Key just said, said, there's that Kendrick Lamar influence behind that. So I kind of get that a lot. So if you mess with our boy K-Dot the way I do. And honestly, I feel like my biggest inspo is Andre 3000. So I get why people would just call out Kendrick a lot, because I feel like Kendrick is also inspired by Andre 3000. You feel me? Like, it's just like the godfather of that whole approach in style. So if you want to hear those type of familiar sounds and just hear good hip hop that ain't about killing and shooting and, you know, getting back to the lyricism and what hip hop really was, then yeah, you should definitely tune in to What Call Me Israel is doing.
That's what I'm talking about, man. I love when I come on this show and we bring all these dope artists on and y'all come on and y'all bring these dope tracks, man. That's what I'm talking about.
I appreciate that. Thank y'all for having me too.
For sure, man. So just before we get up out of here, though, just give all the people your social medias and stuff like that so they can get in tune with your movement.
You can find me on all social media platforms at @callme_Israel. That's Israel spelled just like the country. I-R-S-A-E-L. Call Me Israel. And also on all streaming platforms as well, my name is Call Me Israel as well. Just one word. So that's Spotify, Tidal, you know, Apple Music, whatever you use, it's Call Me Israel.
For sure, man. We got two more interviews after that one, man. We're going to be right back in tune with y'all. It's Fusion Radio with Brian Stinson and YTS Keys.
Whoop.